بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The verse that Shah had read in the khutbah today, محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم. When it was revealed, after this, the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked questions from his companions on many occasions that when you say all the faithful will be rohama banahum, kind amongst each other, kind to each other, compassionate to each other, what does it exactly mean? So the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, again not on once, many occasions, because it occurs in many hadith, explained that one moment, one faithful, one Muslim has got many rights on the other Muslim, and he enumerated those things. There is a set of these things. Some of these, there is one set of things, like this one, that whenever they meet together, they should say salutations, assalamu alaikum, to each other. Then if one of the brothers goes away on a journey, etc., or jihad, the other brother should look after his family and his other interests left behind. He should keep an eye on those things. Then if a brother or sister asks for some advice, give them good advice. If they share a secret with you, then keep that secret for them. Such rights of one. If a brother or sister dies, his say a funeral prayer. This is a right of one Muslim or other. Amongst this whole list, there was one thing that the Holy Prophet mentioned, and that is when a faithful, a mu'min, falls ill, go and visit them and inquire about them. Console them, cheer them up, support them, visit them. So this ayahat of visiting a sick moment, sick person, is amongst that list of the rights of Muslims against each other. Now, when explaining this then, how a brother or sister should visit an ailing brother or sister, he mentioned, when you go, pay your salutations, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, seek permission to sit down when you are allowed to sit down, seek permission to enter and then sit down and sit down. And right from the beginning, think that you are not going to sit there for very long. Make your visit very short. Plan your visit a short visit, because you don't understand, a patient cannot take the burden of visitors. Obviously, you would like to engage him in conversation. He or she is not in a mood or not capable of entering into conversation. Or he or she might have to go for personal needs. Maybe he or she is not fully dressed. A patient has got many limitations. So try to make your visit a very, very short visit. And what should you be doing in that visit? One thing you don't do, and one thing you do. What you don't do is that don't mention such things to that patient that are depressing. Don't talk about his illness, that such and such other person, he also had the same condition as you had. He remained sick for 2 months, he said, such and such passed away, he remained sick for 2 days before dying, etc. Don't talk about depressing things to them at all. So this was the don't. And what, cheer him up. Tell him that don't worry, this is a minor thing. Inshallah, with God's grace, very soon you'll be up and about and doing normal things, etc. Try to cheer up the patient. And then, what should you should be doing? End your visit with a prayer. Prayer for the health of that person. Right there, in loud voice, say, before I go, I want to pray for you. Raise your hand. And then the Holy Prophet also taught a prayer for this occasion. And that prayer is, perhaps I can reproduce the Arabic words, that Izhabil Bas, Rabban Nas, Ishfe, yes, the name of the person. The name of the person. And then we say that Shifan Kamilan Lardawadu Sakama. That, O Lord, the Shifa, the healing lies with you. All the Shifa is with you. So my request is that you heal this person, give this person health, restore this person to full health and to non-recurring. It should not be coming again, and also none of it remaining. Make it a complete recovery of this person, and say this prayer for them before leaving them, and then again pay your salutations and come back. So the theme of this is that, which is repeated in another hadith, is that when you go console and cheer up a sick person, make your visits short. That is in a nutshell the Holy Prophet's emphasis on this. And what you should be doing in the time available? Talk of good things and say that prayer. And that's for today. Thank you.